Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today, let's listen to this beautiful prize-winning 73rd Independence Day speech. If you're watching my video for the first time, consider subscribing. You can listen to all the explanations of lessons pertaining to classes 10, 11 and 12. And don't forget to press the notification button so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. So let's move on to the speech. Any speech should have the following components. It is ideal to begin your speech with a quote. Since this is pertaining to independence, you can use some beautiful quotes on freedom. And then this should be followed by greetings. You have to greet the audience sitting in front of you. Then comes the salutation. By salutation, you mean to address all the dignitaries and other people sitting in front of you. This is followed by the introduction of your topic and then the discussion where you give all your arguments and then finally the conclusion. In conclusion, don't forget to give a call to action. Now I am beginning my speech with these two beautiful quotes on freedom. Nothing is more precious than independence and liberty. But that doesn't mean doing anything at any time. Freedom is responsibility. Freedom is discipline. And freedom is growth. Then comes my greetings and salutation. Greetings to all of you. Honorable chief guest of the day, respected principal, my dear teachers and dearest friends gathered here. Then comes my opening and introduction. I feel extremely proud to stand before you and talk to you about the significance of this day. Today is Independence Day. India is celebrating her 73rd Independence Day. This is the most befitting moment to remember the sacrifices of millions and millions of named and unnamed heroes who shed their precious blood for the sake of our independence and what we have been doing for the past 72 years. Today, we enjoy the fruit of freedom. Surely, we are indebted to the innumerable heroes of the past. Who can forget the charismatic leaderships of Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, Lokamanya Tilak, Jhansi Rani, Shivaji, Bhagat Singh, Subhash Chandra Bose and many more who led the freedom struggle movement in India. All through their lives, they had only one vision. It was a free India, where the Indians would be ruled by Indians and people would be free to follow their rights. Finally, after a lot of bloodshed, sacrifices and demonstrations, India was free on the 15th August of 1947. From there on, India was on her path of development. Today, after 72 years of growth and development, India can be proud of a few golden feathers adorning her cap. India's top 5 achievements include maintaining its unity and integrity, remaining a vibrant democratic country, developing programs that are specific to common man, India's space program and her nuclear and missile programs. Apart from these, India has commendable achievements in the field of sports, commerce, entertainment, education, infrastructure and agriculture. Independence is our priceless possession. The new generation has to be really aware of all the sacrifices and bloodshed that have gone into the making of the free and prosperous nation. Let's look at the concluding passage. A country can be proud of its people when it is sure that its independence and overall growth is secure in the hands of the future generations. Before concluding, I would like to reiterate the quote of Mahatma Gandhi. He said, "A nation's culture resides in the hearts and souls of its people." Hence, it's our duty to safeguard our country and its interests in all respects. Let us all together celebrate the 73rd Independence Day by unfurling the tricolor and paying rich tributes to our freedom fighters. With great delight, let me reiterate that I am indeed proud to be an Indian. Happy Independence Day to all of you. Jai Hind! I hope you like this video. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to my CBSE English teacher. Like, share, and give your valuable comments. Thank you for watching.